too, a dead woman in the machine.
I'm an instrument. Manufactured by a machine. Born in destruction and fire.
To quench the flames and heal the world. How tragic to learn you're a person of towering importance. It seems you have a destiny to fulfill.
I love how science, like, just get over yourself. You're literally the thing that we need to save this world, and you're having a conniption fit? Oh, please.
So when you're done feeling sorry for yourself, go to the Bitter Climb. I'll be waiting above in Gaia Prime's ruins.
Holy crap.
Identiscan had function rectified. The Wiki line. Route 1 access unsealed.
Ooh, yep. Hello. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, going up. Wrapped around.
Aloy, forgive. Forgive. The goddess spoke to you?
She did.
What did she say?
That I was born to lift a curse, to kill a metal demon.
How, Aloy? How?
I don't know yet. But she told me where to go to find out.
And you will do this?
It yeah? Was
her wish. What she made me for. Yes, I will do it. I'll try anyway.
All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora. All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora. All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora.
First you shun me, now this? I will not be worshipped. I'm not your anointed. I don't belong to you. There's a whole world beyond your borders, whole tribes of people just as good as you. And it is all in danger. It's a world worth fighting for. Not just here, everywhere.
How can we help?
If you can fight, and you're willing, go to Meridian and wait for me there.
As Aloy says, so it shall be.
Make way
that she may forge the path for others to follow.
Right. You know, I'm wondering for the second game, are we gonna be like correcting some it's just like, hey, just a FYI.
Aloy, how kind of you to spend a moment with me before you depart. There can be no doubt now. You are a blessing made flesh, the will of the goddess incarnate.
You know,
it's really not that simple, Tirsa, but I guess it's close enough.
I know the path ahead will be dangerous. To kill a metal devil sounds impossible, but I believe in you.
Thanks.
Thank you.
So about Rost?
Tirsa, I want to know Rost's story. Why he was made an outcast. He never told me. Said he took an oath of silence. What did he do?
Oh. Yes, that.
What crime did he commit?
I will tell you if you wish. But it is a long story. Are you sure you want to hear it now?
Yes.
Of course I want to hear it. Tell me.
Rost never committed any crime. He was an outcast by choice.
What? What do you mean?
Many years ago, before the derangement, before the Red Raids, a band of murderous outlanders, 12 in number, struck without warning. At Mother's Vigil, they took hostages, and then pressed on, headed for Devil's Thirst.
Mother's Vigil? Where's that?
You would know it as the Forsaken Village, near the Karja border. But at the time, many families lived there. Rost's was one of them. His mate was killed fighting the Outlanders, and his daughter was among those taken hostage.
His daughter? What was her name?
Alana. She was just 6 years old.
Nora Braves couldn't stop 12 Outlanders? Or rescue the hostages?
It was quite impossible. We outnumbered them, but every time a Brave came within bowshot, the Outlanders killed a hostage.
What did they come here to do?
That was never discovered. We couldn't track closely enough to observe them. We know they camped beyond Devil's Thirst for 2 days. There were reports of strange noises. And then, as suddenly as they came, the Outlanders made their way back to the border and disappeared.
What happened to Rost's daughter? She was killed.
Rost was one of the Braves who tracked the Outlanders, keeping his distance. There were 6 hostages still alive when they reached the border, Alana among them. Rather than release them, the Outlanders slit their throats and left the corpses just across the border, mocking us.
Why?
Cruelty. They knew the faithful Nora would not leave the sacred land to collect the bodies, let alone pursue them. They thought themselves safe from our vengeance.
Are you saying that Rost went after them? That he became an exile?
No. Rost was beside himself with grief, but even so, he would never have broken taboo.
Then what did he do?
He called upon the most terrible and secret rite of the Nora tribe. He begged to be made a Death Seeker.
A Death Seeker? What is that?
One who dies to go seeking. And in seeking, brings death to others. The ritual drags the spirit from one's body, releasing it to all Mother's care. The heart beats, the mind thinks, but the spirit has moved on.
I don't understand.
Rost went after the Outlanders, but his spirit never left. It remained here with All Mother. He gathered the bodies of the slain and returned them. And then he set out in pursuit, not as an exile, but a weapon of vengeance. A barbed arrow shot from a bow, never to return.
So, he didn't break taboo, but he broke taboo because he became their weapon?
But Rost did return.
Yes. A full year later. And terribly wounded. He collapsed at the border of the Sacred Land. A hunting party came upon him. He was delirious. In agony. By law, he should have died where he lay. But one of the hunters broke taboo. And reaching across the border, she dragged him to our side.
Who was she?
A Brave who'd lost a mate and 2 sons to the very Outlanders that Rost pursued.
So, Rost never finished his mission.
To the contrary, he killed all 12. Tracked them to disparate places the world over, he said.
Okay. I know we're getting Horizon 2. right? And I know it's going to be Aloy. But, hot damn. You know how they have Miles Morales as a standalone game? Standalone game of Ross being younger and just being like a total badass hunting down people? 12 people. 12 different areas. All unique. Come on, let's do this.
Meridian. Bun-Ur. The Claim. Utaru Land. Further even, into the Forbidden West. The last he killed nearly got the best of him. Wounded, he stumbled and crawled back to us, hoping to die as close to the sacred land as he could. He never expected nor asked to be dragged across the border and nursed back to health. That was done to him. Leaving us, the matriarchs, in a difficult position.
Why couldn't you just welcome him back?
Rost had been made a Death Seeker, Aloy. He no longer had any place among the tribe. By law, he should have been driven back out. But we couldn't bring ourselves to do that, so we offered a compromise.
You made him an outcast?
Yes. We offered to do so on the condition he never speak to anyone of this exception.
After all he did, all he suffered, to be declared an outcast was his reward.
Rost was overjoyed. He never expected to live another day in the sacred land, let alone the embrace so close to the goddess. He resolved to spend the rest of his days in solitude, and was happy to do so.
Agvi, morning, buddy.
But then you found me, and gave me to him.
Yes. Another compromise. The matriarchs feared you, and would not let you be raised by the tribe. And so we turned to Rost. I knew that he would take care of you, bring you up, teach you to worship All Mother and respect the ways of the tribe.
You didn't root that out now, did it?
You certainly tried anyway. You took a man who'd lost his daughter and made him raise an infant girl. Doesn't that strike you as callous?
I'm inclined to think the course of events has shown the wisdom of our choice.
Girl, you got lucky and you damn well know it. Don't be acting like we had wisdom.
And I'm quite certain that from the moment he laid eyes on you, he saw you as a gift and never a burden.
All right, Tirza, that's quite a story.
To be really fair, though, we should get a standalone game with Rost as a, like, young man or young brave becoming a Death Seeker and then just going to town on these guys. Make it like a Punisher-esque game, right? Make the deaths unusually, you know, gory.
It's time for me to move on. I thank you for doing what you could to help me through the years and for telling me
right?
this story.
Like, again, he
I
went into the Forbidden
more.
West. So,
but
we're going there as
I
Aloy, but that'd be a really good time.
No need to sell ourselves short.
Oh, thank you, Aloy. I will pray for you.
Okay, I guess it can't hurt.
His blessing made flesh. She will destroy the corruption that still spreads through the world.
Okay.
The anointed.
Oh my god, no, stop calling me the anointed. I'm not like some tool for your like mysticism to be. I'm gonna shoot you right here. As an anointed, before I renege my anointed status. Damn it. I'm gonna take his ass out. Finish you. See, it makes me, knowing that Apollo as a subroutine got separated, those are flying arrows, or floating arrows, got separated from the rest of the group, that means that everything that we had got screwed over. Who screwed us over? Somebody messed with Hades. And when we find out, kick some ass to the bitter climb.
Easing. Clouds will part soon.
Ooh, that's so pretty, chat. All right. Continue pushing the story. I feel like after this, we are hitting endgame. And that is a lone thunderjaw. Plural! Moho! There's three! No, two. Go? Gotta go? Gotta go a lot faster. A lot faster. Can barely take on one. Yes. Somebody
those
take out a.
Must be here for the scrap.
Oh. He's all yours, guys. Oh shit. Serpentine. Already in your end game. Yep. At least it feels like it anyway. We did get our toe in the DLC though. Oh, I really hope that Forbidden West, Guerrilla Studios is like, you know what? We kind of like the quick grab in Ghost of Tsushima. Like that needs to be like an automatic. This is gonna be a climb in it. Ain't gonna be a climb here. Oh, damn this game. Alright, can you hop this?
I guess I can't blame you for that.
Okay. Get out of here. Oh, the rope. That's not the rope. That's the rope. On the road again. Can't wait to get back on the road again. Climbing up again. Always dealing with the climbing of the wall. What level are we? Out of curiosity? Ooh, we're 34. Okay, cool. Let's grab that.
Ferocious machines prowl every step of the climb.
More corrupted.
Not corrupted, but they will not tolerate humans.
So what else is new?
Hold on. Is there something new on this? I'm more than positive. We've seen everything the base game has to offer, right?
Stalkers in the open. Watchers on the other side.
Well, they're not corrupted though, right? Roy, what destroyed them? God, why I feel like I'm gonna find out here in a second. There's someone in this area that I'm not seeing? No? Okay. Oh, it's the invisible guys. I forgot about them. Slide!
Almost.
You are mine, little buddy. All right, I'm gonna go grab one of your friends. We're gonna have a posse. God, I mean, that was a good slide. Run, Fox. Run.
Later.
Woo! Wait. Oh. Well, they're gonna have fun. Little windy. Oh, I did not even see that. And she is so lucky. Whoever put those platoons in.
Do they think they're guarding Gaia?
I doubt they think at all. More like an instinct, gathering them to her grave.
That sounds ominous. Red eye. Yoo-hoo! Come pull a geeky geese. There we go. You, my friend, are now what we like to say in the biz as the bait. Debate's gonna last. Like that. Whoa! Aloy, go! Ooh. Oh, God. Hey, in my defense, I thought I was fine.
Here they come.
Can I get the big kitty? No. Bro, we gotta go. Nope. Looking at these ledges, these mighty, mighty ledges. Yep. No. Run, baby, run.
Helpful.
Well, if I can barely see them, I'm hoping they can barely see me. See how that works? I don't think they can barely see me. Nope. Okay. I love how I can see the bird just like land on the... Oh, he's gone. He was there a second ago. Not the bird I was talking about. That's new. Okay. Woo! So, mighty big. Wait a minute. Does that look like, holy. Funny, I can't look up that high. Boop. Are you just... Holy crap! Still the main game. We did a little bit of the DLC though. That is a mighty big bird.
Almost there.
That is a
quick time.
See, the thing is, I want to kill it. And I've already racked up a mighty good death count. So it's not like it's doing anything bad. Whoop! Man, knock that shit off, man. How is the bird? Bird is somehow upright while still being unconscious. Big Bird, you want to come down here, or do we want to really have a conversation, huh?
There.
You're coming down. Nope. I lied.